Hello and welcome back to Let's Play Lure of the Temptress. I forgot to mention that there are a couple other Let's Plays of this game. I don't know, I haven't checked walkthroughs or playthroughs or anything like that. Gameplay. But there are two Let's Plays. One is by Mallin, M as in Mary, 50. And another one is by someone else and it's in German. I don't think there are enough Let's Plays of this game. Hopefully you guys feel it warrants a Let's Play. Right. Can you tell me where to find the blacksmith? No, my lord, I've never trusted blacksmiths, not since my sister went to have her teeth pulled. I was never the same after that. That's a dentist. Alright, so there was nothing here to look at, correct? Alright. Statue. And I hear dogs. The stern face of the granite warrior conveys its unspoken message with clarity. Keep out. What does this one say? Ditto. Anything new for Rat Pouch to say? I canceled out. Yep, same old. The gates. Look at gates. The massive gates were built to withstand the mightiest of siege engines and battering rams. And apparently I can't do anything with them. But I can go this way. Okay. Obstructed by a row of bottles containing brightly colored liquids. Herbal remedies and preparations. Nothing new to say. Plain and unadorned. Oh, we have several ways to go. Hey, sir. Yes? What? Where are you going? I want to talk to him. He has something he wanted to tell me. Oops. What is Squirrel up to? Okay. Is that what you wanted to tell me about? Let's get in here. It's locked. Pick the lock with the knife, no. Alright, I don't feel safe with this guy walking around here. Hello? I don't know. It's like he wants to tell me something, but I don't know how to... tell this, get the conversation started. If there is one. Okay. More water, only slightly less nasty than the sewage, at least. The crystal waters of the natural spring have been channeled through the gaping mouth of a carved head. Hello. Flabby face and bulbous neck can suggest a gross and clumsy man, but his movements are controlled and precise. Above his ruddy cheeks, his eyes twinkle as if in silent amusement at the world around him. Sounds like an interesting fellow. Let's talk to him. No. Get back here. Alright, too late. Or he didn't want to wait for me. These people don't want to talk to me. The animal is grazing with a contented single-mindedness and complete disregard for the affairs of humans and squirrel. He's lucky. I can't talk to any of these people. Will this person talk to me? Okay. Gwyn, stranger, what is your name? Gwyn, they call me, sir, and I thank you for asking. I've lived in Turnvale since I was a child, and what stories I could tell you, but not that I'm one for gossip. Well, in a place the size of Turnvale, you've got to mind your own business. Speak not ill of your neighbor, Gwyn, that's what I tell myself. And my neighbors, what a pair. Never a day goes by without their shouting and banging all hours of the night, and it's the child I feel sorry for, sir. Poor little mite. Oh, the sorrows of this world. I ain't one to gossip, but you ain't heard it from me. Can you tell me where to find a blacksmith? That man, if he's not at the forge, then I'd try the magpie or the severed arms. I'm not one to criticize, but Lutheran spends as much time lifting a bile as he does his hammer. I know he's not had an easy life looking after his mother the way he does, but that's no reason to turn to drink, is it now? Still, perhaps he'll settle down and marry Gwyn? She owns the apothecary shop, you know. If you want to cure a potion, she's the one to see. My piles would be the death of me if not for her. She is, probably inspired by, inspired by a character from, In Living Color. He is a large man with receding hair and huge muscles in his arms, his rough hands scarred and calloused. His face is stern, but his eyes are those of a gentle giant. And he's gone. Who is anyone else going to stop by? And how many different NPCs will we have flying through here? What? These people are busy. All of them will talk to you. Alright, I'm gonna move on if the next person doesn't talk to me. Okay. Someone called me and hung up right away. And there they are again. I don't know who that is. Well, I don't know. No one else is coming by now, so let's go this way. Interesting. The huge stone figure seems curiously out of place in this setting. It shows little signs of weathering, and the grass around the pedestal is newly planted. Okay. There's Gwyn. There's my buddy. Ask. I just want to see what she says. Now, why on earth are you asking me? I'm a busy woman, you know. What with the shopping and things like that, I haven't got time to get to stop and gossip. Not like some. Hi. Talk to me. And you talk to me. This one stops, okay. Greetings, stranger. What is your name? I'm Mallin. I must say you've an honest face for a peasant, and in my line of business, that counts for a lot. What is your line of business? Buying and selling. There's a golden opportunity waiting for the right man. No catches, cash in hand. What do you say? Sure. Tell me what I have to do. Take this worthless gold-colored metal bar to Ewan, the shopkeeper. He'll reward you well. What's this? Okay. Large heavy metal bar. Blacksmith. Yes, of course I can. He'll be in his forge. Alright. Not this door. Locked. No key to unlock it with. Question mark. He's got a question mark over him. Open. He opened the door and then just closed it and didn't go through. Okay. Maybe there's some kind of pathing problem here. Oh, he's leaving now. I'm in his way. What's through here? They're slowing down a little. Here's someone. What name describes the eagle in the sky? Who knows the secret name of the otter in the stream? How can you tell one end of a worm from the other? Are you mad? Seek the answers to these questions. He slumped against the wall like a pile of dirty laundry. His beady eyes scanned the courtyard. There's Gwyn. I don't know. Oh, here's a status. Oh, here's what we're carrying. I have a groat and a broken glass, a knife and a metal bar. Okay. So if you click on nothing, you can examine these items. This metal bar, made from a soft yellowish metal, pleasing to the eye and heavy in the hand. It seems like gold to me. A fool's gold, possibly. Okay, and we can look at the room here. Magpie Courtyard. The cobbled square is dominated by the tavern and heavy with the smell of ale. Above the door hangs a weather-beaten sign. A faded painting of a magpie adorns the sign. From the bird's beak hangs a chain bearing a pale blue gem. Yes. Ooh, a squirrel in there. Notice. This establishment is permanently closed. The proprietor would like to thank you for your custom. Oh, okay. They also say that in Beneath a Still Sky, after the doctor... It's a long story, but basically he puts a hole in your head in exchange for your balls, and he says, thank you for your custom. So, the door. Sure, we can't get in there. Let me go in there. Magpies.